Welcome to the viewers for the lecture on structural analysis. So already we had three lectures, 91, 92, and 93, on moment distribution method. We have already introduced the method, and we have done a few problems on finding out the distribution factors, finding out the rotation at a joint, etc. And we have solved gate questions. And in the last lecture, we have done a problem on continuous beams. That is again a gate problem. So the earlier case, the continuous beam was loaded with a uniformly distributed load, and also the beam was subjected to a settlement. So that we have discussed earlier. That was a gate problem. Now we will again take another continuous beam problem. Now here the beam is subjected to a moment, a couple at some intermediate point. So every problem we will make some changes so that we need not repeat the same problem. So there will be some new information, right? Now here let us take a problem on a continuous beam. So a continuous beam ABC. First, we'll see the figure and come back. So this is the continuous beam ABC. AB is of 6 meters, BC is of span 4 meters, and the beam AB is subjected to a clockwise moment of 180 kilonewton meter at 4 meters from the left hand support. 4 meters from the left hand support, so that this is 2 meters, span is 6 meters, right, 180 kilonewton meter. And the span BC is subjected to a central concentrated load of 180 kilonewtons. Now going to the problem, right, a continuous beam ABC is fixed at the ends and loaded as shown in the figure. Find the reactions and support moments using the method of moment distribution. Draw the bending moment and the shear force diagrams, right. So coming to the problem, we know the first step is finding out the fixed end moments, right. So we will start with the first step, fixed end moments. In span AB is subjected to a clockwise moment of 180 kilonewton meter at 4 meters from the left hand support. That means A is 4 meters, B is 2 meters, L is 6 meters, right. So M of AB equal to the formula is, when it is subjected to a clockwise moment, as far as fixed end moments are concerned, both will be clockwise, both will be plus, and we have to find out the value, right. It may be equal to M B by L square into 3 A minus L. This is the formula, subjected to only a moment, right. Now here the value of M is 180, B is 2 meters, L is 6 meters into 3 into A equal to 4 meters minus L equal to 6 meters. 180 into 2 by 6 square into 3 into 4 minus 6. Now this value will be equal to 60 kilonewton meter. Kilonewton meter, right. Then M of B A equal to M of B A equal to M A by, formula is M A by L square, M into A by L square into 3 B minus L. 3 B minus L. So M is 180, A is 4 meters by L square into 3 into B is 2 meters minus L is 6 meters. So here B is 2 meters, so 3 into 2 is 6. 6 minus 6 is equal to 0. Therefore, M of BA will be equal to 0. So this will be the case. Right. M of BC, it is subjected to a central concentrated load, therefore minus WL by 8, minus WL by 8 equal to minus W is 80, L is 4 meters by 8 equal to minus 40 kilonewton meter. M of CB equal to WL by 8 equal to 80 into 4 by 8 equal to 40. Right. This is usual step where we have done number of problems on slope deflection method and also already problems on moment distribution method. So this is not a new information. Right. Next one is that of distribution factors. The second step is distribution factors. So we know the columns are joint, member, relative stiffness, we'll call it as RS, total stiffness, TS, and distribution factor. DF equal to the relative stiffness by total stiffness. So that's about the tabulation. Right. Now, in this problem, here, it's a two-span continuous beam. So, the support A has got only one member. Therefore, there is no question of distribution. Entire moment will be taken by AB itself, right? Now, coming to joint B, more than one member. You have got member BA and member BC. So, when there are two members or more members, there will be distribution, right? So member BA and BC, joint is B, the members are BA and BC. Then joint C again has got only one member. Therefore, for A and C, we need not provide the tabulation, right? So only for joint B, where there are two members, you have to provide. One member is BA, the other member is BC. Right. For BA, yes, the far end is fixed and I is uniform for the entire length and L is 6 meters. For BC, L equal to 4 meters. So, if these values we can remember, we will be able to do it. Now it is I by L. When far end is fixed, it is I by L. For the first span BA, it is I by 6, right? For the second span is again I by L because C is fixed. So here it is I by 4. I equal to this value. Right. Now coming to sum. I by 6 plus I by 4 equal to, we will take LCM. LCM, let us take it as 12. So that this will become 2i plus 3i. That is equal to 5i by 12. This is the sum. 5i by 12. Now coming to distribution factor, for number BA, it is I by 6. I by 6 into, we can write it as 12 by 5i. As we have discussed earlier, relative stiffness is I by 6 divided by total stiffness is 5i by 12. Actually, this you have to show it in one case. So, therefore, this is I by 6 into 12 by 5i. You have to show this somewhere to show that you know the concept, right? So, this is equal to say 12 by 6 2, so this value equal to 0.4, so 6 by 12 by 6, this will become 2 by 5 equal to 0.4, right? So here it is I by 4 into 12 by 5i, so this and this will give 3. I and I will get cancelled. Therefore, this value 3 by 5 equal to 0.6. So, these are the distribution factors. Only one joint which requires distribution. That's all. Right. So, next one is that of moment distribution. The third step is moment distribution. So for moment distribution, we know first one is joint, you got joint A, then joint B, then joint C. These are the three joints. Coming to members, here you got only one member, member AB. For this you got two members, member BA and member BC, and here you got only one member, namely CB, right? Then distribution factors. Distribution factor. AB, there is no distribution factor, forget about this. CB, there is only one member, no distribution factor. Now, coming to member BA, it is 0.4 and BC, it is 0.6. Therefore, for BA, it is 0.4 and BC, it is 0.6. So, these are the Now here, coming to the vertical lines, so here you have to provide a vertical line. So first column contains what we are doing in the process, moment distribution process. So this you can draw it fully. Here BA and BC belongs to joint B, therefore this is how we have to draw. So and coming to CB, there is only one member and here a vertical line. Now the point is, coming to this vertical line, you need not draw vertical line for all cases. AB and BA forms one span, AB and BA. Similarly, BC and CB form one span. Therefore, here we have to draw the line continuously. So this is very important. We need not draw all vertical lines. So AB and BA together, BC and CB together. Similarly, here B is common to BA and BC. Should not draw a vertical line in the first row. That is, so if these two points are remembered, then it's not a difficult process. So first, fixed end moments. Now fixed end moments already we have got. So minus 60, 0, minus 40, plus 40. So those values will have to bring it here. So this is 60 minus, plus 60. First value is plus 60 because we applied a clockwise moment. Therefore, this is 60.00. This is 0. This is minus 40.00. This is plus 40.00. And here in this problem, A is fixed, B is continuous, C is also fixed. They will take moment. Therefore, there is no need for releasing any support. So that is the point, right? Now coming to this problem. So there is no question of releasing A or C over. Now straight away we can start balance. So balance or distribute, because this is moment distribution method. Some books will give distribute. Distribute is correct, balance is also correct, right? So let us use the term balance. You have to balance the joint B. Joint B, in BA you got a moment of 0, in BC we got a moment of minus 40. So when these two, if the joint B is in equilibrium, these two values when added must be equal to 0. So here 0 minus 40 equal to minus 40. Therefore, it will not be under equilibrium. So balancing means you have to make it a 0. So to make it a 0, what you have to do? You have to apply plus 40. When you apply plus 40, that will become 0. Plus 40 should not be applied at BC only. It has to be distributed to BA and BC. In what ratio you have to distribute? That you have got the distribution factor. Based on the stiffness of the individual members, we have calculated how much distribution is to be for BA, how much distribution is for BC. So BA will carries 40% of the moment, BC will carries 60% of the moment. Therefore, minus 40 is the unbalanced moment. So you have to apply plus 40 is the balancing moment. So this is the unbalanced moment. Therefore, 40 out of 40, 40 into 0.4 for the member BA and 40 into 0.6 for the member BC. 40 into 0.4 equal to 16. 40 into 0.6 equal to 24. plus, because balancing moment is plus 40. Therefore, for BA, you have to apply 16.00. For BC, you have to apply 24.00. So that when these two values are added, minus 40 plus 24 will become minus 16. So left hand side plus 16, right hand side minus 16, balanced, right. Next, joint A need not be balanced, there is only one member. Joint C need not be balanced because there also only one member. So what I want to say here is, you are not going to distribute moment at any other joint, therefore there is no possibility of carryover from C to B or carryover from A to B. There is no chance. Therefore, balancing is over. When balancing is over, you have to carry out, balance and carry over. Therefore, 16 by 2 equal to, this will become 8.00. 24 by 2 equal to 12.00. Normally, we will not do in other cases. So, in this case, there is no other joint to be balanced. Therefore, this is the only step, straight away final moments. Straight away you can go for. Therefore, carry over, you can do it in the same step, right. So, these are the final. Final moments, 60 plus 8 equal to 68.00, and this is 16.00, this is minus 16.00, 40 plus 12 equal to 52.00, these are the final moments. So, this completes the determination of the final moments as far as this problem is concerned. Right. Next, we have to draw the bending moment diagram. Now, here, in the case of AB and BC, so here it is plus 68. The value is, this is clockwise, 68.00. Here the moment is plus 16. Plus 16. This is minus 16. And this value is plus 52. 52.00. You can check it up. So, first one is plus. Second one is also plus. Third one is minus. Fourth one is plus. So, all moments are clockwise. This is clockwise. This is clockwise, this is clockwise, this alone is anticlockwise, right. So, this is the, this will give you the support moment diagram. This will give you, so here, because this will cause tension at the bottom, this will cause tension at the top. This will cause tension at the top. This will cause tension at the top. Right. Therefore, plotting on the tension side, this will be 68.00. Here it is 16.00. And here it is 52.00. So, this is about the support moment. Right. Therefore, this will be the support moment diagram. Support moment diagram will be, of course, it is not proportionate. Of course, you can understand. No problem, right. Right. So that is about the support moment diagram. This is 68.00. This value is 16.00. This is 52.00. Right. Now we have to superimpose the simply supported bending moment diagram. Now here the span AB is subjected to a moment, a couple, 180 kilonewton meter, a moment 180 kilonewton meter at 4 meters from the left hand support. So for this you have to do the calculations. That is AB is subjected to a clockwise moment of 180 kilonewton meter. This is 4 meters, this is 2 meters, this is 2 meters. Therefore, let us call this as RA, call this as RB1, because you have another span, RB1. So, the distance is 6 meters, right. Now, when we take moment about B, RA into 6 meters plus moment is 180. RA into 6 plus 180 equal to 0. Because we are going to draw the simply support moment diagram, here you should not think about the support moments. So we are treating AB as a simply supported beam. Later in the calculation of reactions, there we will find out for drawing the shear force diagram, you have to add MAB and MBA also. So here we are treating AB as a simply supported beam. Forget about MAB and MBA in this step, right. The purpose we have to understand. Therefore, we will find RA equal to minus 180 by 6 equal to minus 30 kilonewton. Therefore, RA equal to 30 kilonewton downwards. Or we can say RA equal to minus 30 here, because you have marked in the upward direction. So this equation is based on RA upwards. Therefore, let us avoid changing the direction, right. Now RB equal to, since there is no other vertical load, RB will have to be 30 kilonewton upwards. RB equal to RB1 equal to 30 kilonewton, because there is no other vertical loading. Therefore, RB1 equal to 30. RB1 equal to 30. Now, we are trying to draw the simply supported moment diagram, right. Now, for getting the simply supported moment diagram, let us take a section XX. Section XX at a distance X from the left hand support, right. Now, MX equal to minus 30 into X. Minus 30 into X. That is the govern. There is no other load. 30 is downwards. Therefore, minus 30 into X. Here, in this case, now, when X equal to 0, MA equal to 0. M equal to 0. When X equal to 0, because 30 into X. X equal to 0. M equal to 0. Right. When X equal to 4 meters. 4 meters. Right. X equal to. When X equal to 4 meters, M equal to 30 into 4, minus 30 into 4 equal to minus 120 kilonewton meter, minus 120 kilonewton meter, right. Then let us consider another section beyond 4 meters, another section beyond this 4 meters. So for this again x is measured only from the left, right, measured from the left. So you can take from RB, that will also be correct, but let us say mx equal to mx. For the second case, mx equal to minus minus RA, namely minus 30, because RA remains the same. We are taking moment from the left. We can take it from the right also, that will be more convenient, no problem. Let us take from the left itself, minus 30 into x. Then there is a moment 180, therefore plus 180, plus 180, plus 180. Therefore, here when x is equal to 4 meters, because this equation is valid only for 4 meters, beyond 4 meters. So, 0 to 4 meters, first equation, 4 to 6 meters, second equation, right. X equal to 4 meters, m equal to 30 into 4, 120. 30 into 4, minus 120, plus 180, equal to 60. Equal to 60 kilonewton meter. When x equal to 6 meters, m equal to minus 30 into 6, minus 180, plus 180, it becomes 0. So here we have accounted this 180 in the second equation. Therefore, one point I want to clarify here. Now, normally sagging moment will be getting with the positive sign. Therefore, we plot it up. Support moment diagram is mostly negative. So, we superimpose on the diagram, because here there is a possibility of a little confusion. So, therefore, this negative I am going to plot it down. Positive I am going to plot it up. Reason is, first one is hugging moment. Second one is sagging moment. So, you should not combine the support moment diagram, because it is negative, you are plotting it upwards. Sagging moment, you are, so we are superimposing the two diagrams. So, this difference one has to understand at this stage. Therefore, this minus 120, I will plot it down, plus, this is a simple support moment diagram, plus 60, I will plot it up, right. Before that, one more point is, now, where this change occurs, this 68 to 16, where it occurs, we have to find out. So, what we have to do is, we have to say 68 by x equal to 16 by 6 minus x, or cross multiplying, that is 68 into 6 minus x equal to 16x, etc. You simplify, we will be getting x equal to 4.857, x equal to 4.857 meters. Therefore, because this location is very important, so this distance, this is 4.85 meters. From here, this is 4. This point occurs at a distance of 4.8. So now we are going to plot this bending moment at 4 meters. Therefore, this value will be 4 meters, it is 120 down, So this value is 120. This value is 120. Same 4 meters, just to the right, it is plus 60. It is plus 60. So this value is 60. So just to the left, it is minus 120. Just to the right, it is plus 60. So this, we have to plot it like this. Because the drawing this, so that is why purposely I have taken this problem. Every problem, there must be some change. So this is the support moment, I mean, simply support moment diagram for the span AB. For the span AB. And for the span BC, it is subjected to central load. Therefore, mu BC equal to W L by 4 as a simply supported beam. So that is equal to W is 80, L is 4 meters by 4 by 4 equal to 80 equal to 80 kilonewton meter. This is for the span BC. So what you have done here is for AB. This is for AB, that is for span BC, right? Therefore, since it is subject to central load, it is 80 this is 80. So this value is 80. Therefore, this is minus, this is plus, this is minus, this is plus, and here this is minus, this is minus, this value is minus, and this value is plus. So you have to consider the common areas which are cancelled, which are cancelled, you have to consider. Therefore, you will find that leaving alone where the negative bending moment and the common, I mean positive bending moment crosses, so you have to just draw the diagram. So this is the negative moment diagram and this is the positive moment diagram. So here this is positive because nothing overlaps. So therefore here because this is positive because 68 is positive, therefore here this is positive, this is also positive, therefore it will come, both are positive, therefore you have to combine both. So both are positive, right? Now here positive and negative cancels each other, therefore this is the net diagram. So drawing this diagram requires a little care, and that is why specifically taken this problem. So this is our bending moment diagram. Bending moment diagram. Right. Now next is the shear force diagram. Next is yes. Shear force. Shear force calculations. Now span AB, AB, this is the moment, this is the moment 180. Now here you have to consider this support moments in the calculation of reactions. What you have done earlier is assuming AB and BC are simply supported, we have drawn the bending moment, simply support moment diagram. So there you should not consider MAB or MBA. Now here you have to consider because we know that MAB is P plus 68, MBA is plus 16. Therefore, here it is plus 68. This we have to consider here. This is plus 16. Similarly, in the span BC, this is minus 16 and this is plus 52. This is, let us say, there we have used RA, RB. Let us call this as VA. VA, VB1, VB2, and let us say VC to avoid confusion. So, this is 16 and this is 52. Clockwise 52. This is anti-clockwise 16. Clockwise 16. Right. So, this is 6 meters, this is 4 meters, and here there is a load of 80 kilonewton. So, in this calculation, we have to consider the support moments MAB and MBA, right. Now, for this, VA into 6 plus 68, VA into 6, we are taking moment about B, VA into 6 plus 68, it's a clockwise moment, plus 180, it's a clockwise moment, 180 is a clockwise moment, plus 16, that is also a clockwise moment. We have considered everything equal to 0. Equal to 0, this will give you VA equal to minus 44 kilonewton. Therefore, VB equal to plus 44. Therefore, VB1 equal to 44 kilonewton. So, this will be downwards and this will be upwards. Therefore, VA equal to minus 44. VB1 equal to plus 44 kilonewtons. Right. Now, coming to this one. So, we have considered all the support moments and the given moment, everything we have considered. So, that is about VA and VB1. Now, coming to this, VB2 into 4 meters minus 16 minus, there is a load, so 80 into 2 meters, because this is 2 meters, this is also 2 meters, 80 into 2 plus 52 equal to 0. So, that will give you VB2 equal to 31 kilonewton. So, this calculation you can do VB2 equal to 31 kilonewton. Therefore, VC equal to 49. So, total load minus VB2 will give you 49 kilonewton. That's about the reactions considering the support moment also. So, this is B and this is C, right, BC. So, that's about the shear force calculations, so that we can easily do it, right. Now, coming to the shear force diagram, right here, VA is minus 44. So, VA is minus 44. VA is minus 44 down, right. Now, from A to B, there is no vertical loading. So, it's only a moment. Therefore, from A to B, it will be horizontal because there is no other vertical load. Now, at B, VB equal to plus 44. Therefore, VB will be up. So, this will close at this point. This is B. This is B. So, this is for. So, this is minus. It is minus, that's all. It is. Right. Now, coming to VC, coming to VB2 and VC, VB2 is 31 up. So, VB2 from this point, VB2 is 31. This is 31. And up to the midpoint there is no load, so here it will be horizontal. Now right, now here there is a downward load 80, so 31 plus 49 it will come down by 80, come down by 80, then there is no load up to the support, therefore it will be horizontal. And here again it is 49 up, because VC is 49 up, so this is VC, therefore this is minus 44 kilonewton, this is 44, this is 31, VB2 is 31 kilonewton, so 31 plus 49 it will come down by 49, so this value will be 49, this is plus, this is minus, so this is 49. This is 49, and here VC is 49 up, so this value is 49. So this is the shear force diagram. So these changes we have to remember. So how to draw the bending moment diagram when there is a moment, when there is a moment. So this requires some concentration so that we can do it without any mistake. And here we need not consider, should not consider the support moments in the calculation, because this is for drawing the simply supported moment. AB is considered as a simply supported moment. So this support moment diagram we have started with fixed ends. So that's all. So coming to this shear force diagram, here we have to consider MAB, MBA, MBC, MCB for drawing the shear force diagram. So if these points are known, we can draw the bending moment diagram and shear force diagram for the given problem. Problem is simple, but because of the moment, it required a lot of discussions. So that completes this problem. Thank you.